there. So all the cups got broke, shots beneath our feet, but it wasn't my fault. Everyone's competing for the love they won't receive, 'cause what this palace wants is release. We live in cities you'll never see on screen. Not very pretty, but we sure know how. To throw my hands up in the air, so there. I'm kinda older than I was when I rebelled without a care, so there. We live in cities you'll never see on screen. Not very pretty, but we sure know how.
Yo, remember back on the Bully when cats used to harmonize like. Yo, my men and my women, don't forget about the dean. This is not the most the king. Yo, it's about a thing.
Feel real good with your hands in the air and lick two shots in the atmosphere.
Since you were looking for your friend, the one you left and never called you again. Remember when he told you he was about to Benjamins? You act like you ain't him, they give him a little trim to begin. Now you think you really gonna pretend like you wasn't down and you called him again. Plus when you ain't even fooling him, if you did it then, and you probably can. Talking out your neck saying you're a Christian, a Muslim, sleeping with the gin. Now that was the sin that did Jezebel in. Who you gonna tell when the repercussions spin? Showing off your thinking it's a trend, girlfriend. Let me break it down for you again. You know I only say it cause I'm truly genuine. Don't be a hard rock when you really are a gem, baby girl. Respect is just the minimum. But you still defending them now. Lauren is only human. Don't think I haven't been through the same predicament. Let it sit inside your head like a million women in Philly pen. It's silly when girls sell their souls because it's sin. Look at where you be in. Hair weaves like it's fake nails done by come again. With his rims and his Timbs and his women, him and his men, come in the club like hooligans. Don't care who they offend, popping yang.
Like you got yang.
Let's not pretend. The one to pack out by the waistman, by the casement, still the name of this basement. The pretty face man, claiming that they did a bid, man. Need to take care of their 3 and 4 kids. Been the face in court case when the money taking, heartbreaking. Now you wonder why women hate me. The sleepy silent man, the punk. Stop acting like boys and be men. How you gon' win when you ain't right within? How you gon' win when you ain't right within? How you gon' win when you ain't right within? Come again.
To you by Sprite. It's the 2K pregame show.
So good to have you with us. Ernie Johnson here. Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports, joined as always by Shaquille O'Neal. The fans are filling the seats out in Boston, the site of our broadcast, and where the Celtics will be going up against the Milwaukee Bucks. Well, for Milwaukee, they split the season series against these guys last season, 2 games apiece. Should be a good one tonight. Hey, Shaq, let's talk about this 6'11 big man, Greg Monroe, out of Georgetown. He's got some offensive skills, doesn't he?
Yes, for a big man, I like him. He has great handle. You know, he's really not going to overpower defenders or elevate above them. So him being a crafty player like he is, it's going to serve him very well, Ernie.
You know,
2K Sports checks in with their loyal viewers with the broadcast from Boston, the home of the Celtics. For the Milwaukee Bucks, they come in off a good outing against the Knicks in New York. And only a single point of separation there. Great game. Right down to the wire.
And I think, Kevin, you know, they really showed how important it is to have a strong bench performance. You go out on the road, you can't rely on your starters night in and night out. The reserves have to contribute and help them out.
I think we definitely saw that, Steve, throughout the game. They were really tied together as a team. Didn't make any difference who was out on the floor. You'll take every road game win you can, and they're happy with that one.
All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. On the court for the Bucks, they've got Greg Monroe, also Brooke Lopez out there. Antetokounmpo is out there with Brandon Knight. And Milwaukee has possession. Pass to Monroe. That's good. About 1 minute into the first. Smart dishes to Davis. And he takes the fantastic lead pass up strong for the slam.
Oh, Maestro, he is so good at making those lead passes, like conducting an orchestra.
And here is Knight. 14 points from him the last game against New York. In low to Monroe. Misses from short range. The Celtics have gone 2-3 here to start out the game.
It's really tough to get that shot off with the size differential there. It's not an individual matchup he's going to win every time, especially in the post.
Very well done. I didn't think he had any business operating down there with the big fellas.
Just over a minute and a half played here in this one. Collects the two-pointer near the hoop. Monroe's got his second bucket.
He's hit the ground running here in the first, putting together a nice quarter offensively.
Howard at the elbow. Now the feed to Davis. Pass to Tyler. Back to Howard. Stolen by Monroe. Here's Antetokounmpo, averaging 6 points per contest. This is the night. Pocket six. Here's Jinks. And no good. Had a chance to take the lead. Here's Tiny. And that one falls, coming off of Davis's feed.
Some weak defensive coverage there. And I'm pretty sure they didn't plan on starting this game out like that, giving such easy access to the rim.
Bucks trail by four. Knight with it. And Davis sends it back. And up the court come the Celtics on the break. Got a piece of it. Time to the pass to Davis. And low to Howard. Boom, he jams it straight down.
Now that was pretty. That was just a nice-looking reverse jam right there.
Use the rim, Clark, to protect the ball, I think, too, a little bit.
Yeah, did a nice job with it.
Yeah, no question, Kevin. Great awareness and terrific finish.
And so it's Milwaukee with it after the basket by Boston. Here's Monroe. Here's Tiny. He's guarded by... And stolen by Knight. And here's the fast break. Knight leading the way. And it's Monroe finishing it off.
Guys, that's simply superb. ball pressure, a run out, and then a dunk in transition.
Exactly, Clark, what they wanted, the aggressive defense to lead to.
Yeah, points in transition.
Yeah, that's why you want to make the other team feel uncomfortable handling the ball, because you can get easy points out of it at the other end.
Smart kicks to Davis. The shot is off. Good work defensively by Monroe. Bucks trail by four. The dish now to Antetokounmpo. Monroe, the pass to Lopez.
Way to play in attack mode and get inside.
And you know, if you're on defense and you're going to foul, make sure it's a good one. They did, preventing the and one.
And a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for the Celtics.
Well, I like the fact they've already been getting a lot of high-quality shots in the paint.
And the other thing we're seeing is great ball movement. We're seeing a lot of good offensive execution, ball movement, player movement, setting up assists.
Lets it go from the wing. Good on the shot.
Don't take your eyes off of him, because he can make plays from multiple spots on the floor. Put the isolated cam on him.
Tipped away. Jinks. And the Bucks miss again.
Very porous defense down there by the hoop. He probably should make that one.
Here's Tiny. A terrific shot on the turnaround. Tiny's got 6 points.
Very positive opening quarter for them. The shots have been falling.
You know, the shooting percentage would be nice if it stayed right there, but that's going to be tough to do.
And so it's Milwaukee now. They trail by six. To the wing on the left. Screen by Monroe. Here is Tiny, coming off a solid outing against Phoenix. He dishes it to Howard. Shoots from the block, and the rebound goes to Lopez. Bucks trail by six. Knight with it, now guarded by Smart. Knight kicks to Monroe. Rebound Boston. They come into this having outplayed Phoenix the last game.
And the thing I took away from that game was how dominant they were on the boards.
Well, it's impossible not to see that domination. Based on the numbers, it was really lopsided in the rebounding battle.
And the Celtics with possession here. Greg Monroe unable to get his shot to go. Antetokounmpo pulls it in.
That's not a sight you see very often. I mean, he has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when he's open.
In this quarter, he's really been off the mark. He just looks a little bit unsettled.
Kicks it to Knight. Looking to end the drought. Lopez with the bucket. So the Celtics call timeout. They're first. And a whole new group out on the floor for the Celtics. A different look for Milwaukee.
And a look at how the Celtics performed over the last month here, Kevin. First in assists, first in shooting percentage. And they're number two in team three-point field goal percentage. They've got a lot of guys who love the three-point shot, and they do a good job of running plays to get those guys open.
Yeah, the one thing that really jumps out at me when you talk about all these stats, Clark, is the assists. And this is a team that has been very unselfish. They're sharing the ball, they're moving, they're really getting a good flow to their offense. And as a result, they're finding pretty high percentage shots almost every possession.
A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Thanks, Kevin. I caught up with the Bucks head coach. He said a big key for them will be containing Carlos Boozer offensively, adding, he's a player who can spread the floor with his jump shot or take you down the block, and it's tough to match his strength inside. Defensively, they'll look to keep length in front of him and limit his offensive rebounding. Sounds like a good game plan, guys. We'll see how they do it.
Thanks, Doris. Young dishes to Boozer. And a strong finish with two hands.
That's a nice finish for the big fella there. I mean, he used his length very well under the basket.
There may be more athletic players around the league, but, Steve, not many bigger ones.
And I'll tell you what, Kevin, I'd like to see him even take advantage of that size more often on the offensive end and be more aggressive.
Here's Thornton, following the bucket by the Celtics. On the wing, Green. Singletary. And there's the whistle, fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
Well, of course, we'd all like to see that free throw percentage improve. I mean, he does not have the touch in the 60s.
And, guys, it's something that he's going to have to work on more and more because he's still not getting the kind of shooting percentage he would like from the line.
Celtics leading by three. Boozer a screen on Thornton. The pass to Boozer. Six on the shot clock. The Celtics need to get a shot off. No one. The Bucks go the other way with it. And up the court come the Bucks. On the break, here's Thornton. Off target at the rim.
Rebounding is going to be the focal point for them in this one, fellas. I can feel it.
Yeah, it's a physical game, and so far the numbers show that they've got the edge on the glass.
And Milwaukee calls their first time out of the game. While we have a moment here, let's reveal the teams that have been holding opponents to the fewest points this month. In fourth, the Bucks.
Well, better protection of the lane the last few weeks, Kevin, has helped them cut down on the easy scoring. They've also done a better job on the mid-range coverage as well, getting to their man quicker and finding ways to clog up the passing lane.
Milwaukee with the ball. It's a five-point game. Singletary. Wide open shot is on the money. 5 points in the game.
Gotta love the use of the bounce pass there. Perfect.
Now a timeout called by Boston. And during the timeout, both coaches getting a chance here to review the strategy at this point of the game, along with the discussions, also some rehydration going on with Gatorade. Everyone trying to bring their top game here tonight.
Yeah, that's why you see the trainers going around to every player, making sure they're hydrated, they're getting enough to drink during the game. So important to hydrate yourself, keep yourself strong and ready to play for these big minutes down the stretch.
Maggette the pass to Young. Nice ball movement by Boston. Poked loose and stolen by Thornton.
Boy, his reaction time to that pass was so quick. Good work defensively.
And that one's good. 56 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Here's Boozer in the post. Second shot opportunity. It's blocked. Thornton passes to O'Brien. Pass to Thornton. And he misses the go-ahead basket.
Even though he missed it, he couldn't pass up that chance.
Yeah, that's an easy jump shot. You got to take that.
Young's shot is off. Milwaukee's gone 0-2 from deep here. Here's Hendricks. Cranes the jumper to finish the break. And the Bucks lead by one.
Great interplay there between those two teammates.
Tam is guarded by Thornton. Here's Tam, blocked, but he stays with it. And still a close game as the first quarter comes to a close. Bucks ahead, up one. And we'll be back shortly for the start. Neither team able to build much of a lead up to this point as we start the second quarter. And an important part of every team's game, a look at the hustle stats for Milwaukee.
And they've come out in attack mode defensively, applying pressure and stealing the ball repeatedly.
And I really think you've got to love the way they've protected the rim today. I mean, a good number of blocks in the first half.
We've got Tiny. Smart is out there with Evan Fournier. Then it's Darrell Wright. And it's Howard in at the five down low. That's the Boston five.
Four of their last five makes came off of a high-quality shot inside.
Yeah, that's textbook basketball, just having their way down low.
Smart kicks to Fournier. Here's Tiny. Good on the three-point shot. Tiny's got nine.
Well, you can't leave him alone, especially from long range.
Milwaukee with the ball. Now Knight. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. And that'll be Milwaukee as it goes out of bounds. Bucks retain possession. Off the inbound. Knocks it loose. And stolen by Wright. Here's Tiny. Lopez over to help. Tiny, the pass to Howard. Out to the right wing. And Fournier gets to Smart. No coverage that time. And the Celtics lead by two.
Nice pass. That one was right on target.
Now Knight, averaging 10 points per contest. In low to Monroe. Howard with the steal. And pushing it up. Here's Boston. Second quarter, we're a little over a minute and a half in. Pass to Tiny. Back to Howard. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two. The Celtics shooting their first free throws of the game. First one falls for him.
Shooting for Boston. Dwight Howard.
And both free throws good for Howard. Bucks trail by four. Now, here is Knight. High post Lopez. Wright's there. On to Tecumbo. Kicks to Monroe. True on the 14-footer. Monroe's got four this quarter.
Fantastic pass. He turned that one into a pretty easy basket for his teammate.
And here's Smart. He's coming off a 16-point game against Phoenix.
Did a great job picking the defense apart, too. It wasn't just his scoring. Give him credit for his passing in that game, too.
Just five on the clock.
Here's where Boston sits right now, Kevin, in the current league rankings. First in shooting percentage. Second in three-point field goal percentage. And they also show up in the top five in assists. They've got scores, and they're a pretty good passing team as well.
And the shooting is really what stands out to me. This is a team that does such a good job of finding open looks. They're unselfish. They work offensively to create good shots. And when they do that, they're on their game. They're tough to beat.
Monroe outside. Here's Jinks. Good on the three-point shot.
And that kind of defense is just not going to cut it, guys. They have to get a hand in his face.
Fires the three. Count that one. And 12 points for Tiny.
You know, he started out hot, and he's only gotten hotter. He could be in for one of those games.
Quarter number two, around 3 minutes gone by. Monroe dishes to Antetokounmpo. He kicks it tonight. Here's Jinks. Trying to come right back with a three of his own. It's no good. Feeds it to Davis. And blocked. And the foul on Marcus Smart. That's his first foul. Boston making a switch here. Clark's checked in.
First team foul. Substitution for the Celtics.
And in the second quarter, a little under 3.5 minutes played already. The feed to Knight. Passes to Monroe. Dishes to Lopez. And the layup's good off the glass. Lopez has got six.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with the way they work down low.
That's become one of the stories of the first half, Clark. Just piling up points in the paint.
Davis sets a screen. Use that pick to get in close.
Wow. The pick worked really well there. Nice job taking it right to the 10 for the layup.
Bucks trail by four. Knight pitch to Antetokounmpo. Here's Monroe. Davis with some nice deep. Boston's got both of their three-point attempts to go down here in the second quarter. The pass to Welch. And again, Boston with the triple.
They really flip things around offensively.
Well, anytime you can make more than half your shots, Clark, you take that any day of the week.
The dish tonight. He feeds it to Antetokounmpo. From 13, Monroe's. Shot is good. Monroe's got 12 in the game.
Well, he certainly isn't the one to blame for them being in the hole. He's been on the money with his game.
Pass to Tyler. And he uses the glass on the way. Tiny's got the lead up to 7 now for Boston.
He's a big reason why they have the lead right now. He's made all of his field goal attempts thus far and remains hot from the floor.
Look at Tiny. He's been really playing well.
He's on fire. They needed to put their heads together to figure out how to get the ball out of his hand.
Green, he's checked in for the Bucks. Bucks trail by 7. Knight on the wing. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. 6 to shoot. Fires from deep. The putback. Great positioning on the putback. 14 points for Greg Monroe.
That's purely a hustle play there. Getting to the offensive glass for the tip-in, well done.
And that's, you know, a quality you see any strong offensive rebounder possess. And we saw it right there.
Yeah, it's the anticipation more than anything. It's understanding where that ball is going before anybody else on the floor does.
They double him with Green. Here's Welch. Davis setting the pick for Smart. And 2 free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. That one on Monroe. For Boston, they have been solid at the line so far. 4 for 4.
And as a team, they're shooting about 75% on the year.
You know, I know that's an aspect they've been trying to address as a team. I mean, they've got to get those free throw numbers up and improve.
Kicks it to Thornton. Lets the 3 fly, and the shot is good. Thornton's got 5 now.
A little bit of a defensive breakdown there. He's not the guy you want to leave open on the perimeter. You've got to stay attached to him.
McGetty with it, averaging 6 points per contest. Comes up empty down low.
Yeah, he's surprised he didn't make that one because he had a pretty clean look at the hoop.
And slam dunk by Smart.
Textbook example there of how to use defense to create offense.
Yeah, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
Yeah, it feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close.
To the inside, stolen by McGetty. And they're pushing it up. Here's Welch. Out of bounds, Milwaukee takes possession. And the Celtics making a change here.
Checking in for your Celtics. Loser.
Yeah. Bucks trail by 5. Here's Green. Good on the shot.
Even with the D lurking, he made it look easy with the soft finger roll.
Boston's gone 3 of 4 from long range in the game. To the paint. McGetty kicks to Boozer. Right side, Boozer tries from 10. And there are the Celtics with another basket. So it's the Bucks now. First chance of the season for them to go up against this Celtics team. Over in the corner, Green. And another 3 for Milwaukee.
That's pretty much been the norm for them, getting their points off assist and great ball movement.
Nice rhythm and flow for this team. Tremendous communication and alertness.
This game's going to take a big swing. Clark, if the D continues to clear out like that and give up easy dunks.
Yeah, that's the kind of defense we expect to see in a blowout, Kevin, or even a exhibition game, not a close game like this.
Look how frustrated Steve is over here.
Well, I just, you know what, Kevin? Come on, Kevin. I just like that he didn't choose to just lay it up. I mean, he threw it down with force.
McGetty outside. Too long in the paint, and he's hit with a 3-second violation. The Celtics shooting their 7th free throw attempt here.
James Young.
And he shows the focus there, nails the technical.
You know, as we've gotten closer to halftime, their style has improved. It's gotten more aggressive, more physical.
It sure seems like it has. They've spent a lot of time at the foul line this quarter.
Can't hit from the corner.
Obviously, they're evenly matched teams on the inside. The rebound numbers are very even.
Yeah, I've been impressed with both teams' energy, just really working hard on the boards.
It just hasn't been a very good day for him, guys. They need him to start burying some of those.
Tam. He's guarded by Thornton. Let's a floater go. That's good. And the Celtics lead by five. Milwaukee's gone 3 of 5 beyond the arc since the start of the second quarter. Now a timeout called by Milwaukee.
Well, he's got to get everybody on the same page. I mean, that's the reason for this timeout. And if that happens, I think they can improve and start playing better.
You know, it's a coach's job to always try to be 2 or 3 steps ahead of the opponent and to look for that extra edge if you can. And I think he feels like he might have seen one.
Right, he's checked in for Boston. 102 left to play in the first half. O'Brien, the pass to Hendricks. Off target with his three.
Their free throw attempts have really fallen off here in the second quarter. Not as aggressive.
Yeah, if they want to avoid going into the half with this deficit, they need to stop settling for these long jump shots and attack the rim.
Here's Boozer. Again, the Celtics good for two.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Yeah, that's 5 of their last 6 baskets inside the lane. They have really established themselves inside.
Here's the screen. Lots of room. That's good on the jump. He's got 9.
Perfect screen there. Set him up with a nice look.
Poor job by the defender to not fight over or around that screen.
Misses the layup. Bucks trail by 5. Green dishes to Thornton. Pass to O'Brien. A floater, and the shot is good.
You know, he's a little bit of an unknown commodity, Kevin. I mean, he may be able to use that to his advantage, sneak up on some folks.
Here's Young from the arc. And